silver slaves in Egypt land. So God took Moses by the hand and said, Moses, tell Pharaoh to set them free. Yeah. But old Moses wanted to wait it out, because in his mind he began to doubt. Said, Lord, old Pharaoh ain't going to listen to me. Well, the Lord said, son, throw down that rod. Moses did, then he cried to God, because it turned to a snake, as evil and wicked as sin. Then he cried again, and it all the way up. The Lord said, seize him by the tail. Moses did, then he turned to a rod again.
God promised him he could scare it out of bondage. He said he'd free them from Pharaoh's evil hands. He said he'd tie and protect them on their journey, and lead them to the promised land.
Moses, I got the power and I'll be with you every hour. Go tell old Pharaoh to set my children free. Moses did, the Lord helped out. He sent the plague through the land about. The old Pharaoh told me to go and let him be. Well, it started out with a cloud by day and a fire by night to lead the way. The old Pharaoh suddenly decided to change his mind. So he gathered together all the soldier band and all the chariots throughout the land. So now let those Israelites go some other time.
Children out of bondage. He said he freed them from Pharaoh's evil hands. He said he'd die and protect them on their journey, then lead them to the promised land.
When they came to the banks of the ocean blue, they turned to Moses and said, what are we doing? Oh, Moses fell on his knees there in the sand. When the Lord said, Moses, trust in God, all you gotta do is raise up that rod and over those mighty waters, stretch forth your hand.
Moses followed Moses' command and watched him parted.
And they saw a path leading to the other shore. Well, the ground was dry and they passed on through some Pharaoh's army that they were too, but the water fell.
To the promised land.